Akoya pearls are jewels of the sea and the pride of Japan. They're also known as the world's first cultured pearls to find commercial success. Japan's pearl cultivation began here in the 19th century in Agobe and Mie Prefecture. Akoya oysters thrived here because of its gentle current and ample plankton, which they feed on. But the tide is turning, a victim of environmental changes. In 2019, local marine industry was in a shock. A massive number of Akoya oysters died. Some analysts say it's 70% of all. In 2020, more died. The local research center identified several causes.
I spoke to expert Takashi Atsumi, who has been researching environmental impact on pearls for more than a decade.
高水温、言ったらずっと水温が高い状態になっているということと、あと餌不足ということがあって、貝はまあ常にその衰弱しやすい状態にあるようです。そういった中にまた新しいそういったあのウイルスなりがあるとですね、あのたくさん貝が死んでしまうということが起こる。
We took a boat to Masaki Island, a hub for pearl cultivation, to meet pearl farmers who are affected. One of them is Tamaki Sato, a third-generation pearl farmer. He's wrapping up harvesting for the season at his farm, which he runs alone. Mr. Sato's business suffered from the mass death of Akoya oysters in 2019. The farm, which has been running for 45 years, faced its biggest crisis. Mr. Sato says he could keep it afloat only because he didn't have to pay wages. He also learned from another mass oyster death episode back in 1996.
あの時は回復するのに15年ぐらいかかりましたけども、今5年ぐらいで、あの、どういうんですかね、光明というか、御花がついてきました。できるだけ、どういうんですかね、あの、アコヤ貝を健やかに、あの、優しく育てるっていう方向の方が、あの、なんか正しいような気がします。
Agobe's pearl farms work with marine researchers who monitor changes in environmental conditions that could affect Akoya oysters. These include the black ocean current, Kuroshio. The warm current, which can also reduce plankton, can cause death in fragile baby Akoya oysters.
こちらが今、三重県の水産研究所のウェブサイトで公開している 気象衛星ひまわりの海面水温画像です。このように、ここが三重県なんですけれど、県で設置している浮き魚礁っていう大きな構造物があるんですけど、そちらにも水温計等を設置していたり。The
data helps pearl farmers shift their farms in Agobe as needed. The farmers aren't the only ones who had to adapt. The amas, or women divers, have for centuries dived in the waters rich with marine life around Mie. They were caregivers of the Akoya pearls until the 1960s. As pearl farming technology advanced, they were no longer needed by the pearl industry. They still dive for shellfish to sell in the market. But Ama Kimio Hayashi says their business of shellfish harvesting is no longer doing well. The 69-year-old thinks she will be the last of her generation. The number of amas in Mie Prefecture has shrunk from more than 4,000 in the 1970s to just above 500, according to a local survey. As traditions like amas slowly fade, so too are businesses with century-long histories. Kashikoshima is the largest island on Agobe. known for its established jewelers selling pearl accessories. But many of their owners are getting on in years. As prospects in Agobe's pearl industry dwindle, younger folks are moving to the big cities to find work. Naoto Yoshimori is the third generation owner of a pearl shop, but the family business may end with him, as his children are not keen to take over the store.
業界もだんだんやっぱりこう人が少なくなってるのは少なくなってますかね。男の子は2人いるんですけど、今はそれぞれ別々の道を進んでるんで、まあともうちょっと自分が頑張って、その後に、まあ、帰ってくるなりしたら、まあ一生懸命じゃなくてもちょっとこう片手間にやってもらえてもいいかな。
On Masaki Island, there used to be 1,000 people working in the pearl industry. Today, there are only 40, many of them elderly. Agobe now has far fewer pearl farms than it used to have, but those who remain in the industry tell me they enjoy their job and hope to continue for as long as they can.
Seoul's subway is a vital mode of transport for its residents and a valuable source of income for many of South Korea's seniors, like Cho Sung-hee. The 71-year-old works as a courier, taking the metro to make deliveries. Rides in the city's sprawling subway network are free for those aged 65 and up. So some courier companies prefer to hire elderly workers, reducing barriers to employment for seniors like Mr. Cho. He follows the route mapped out on an app to get to the recipient's address. He hands over the parcel, and the job is done. Then it's back to the office for another round of deliveries.
안녕하세요. 하루에 제가 풀타임 하면 한 4만 원, 오후에만 나올 경우는 한 2, 3만 원, 2만 원 정도. 양해만 구하고 언제든지 내가 빠질 수 있으면 빠지고 거기에 이해해주고 내 마음대로 움직일 수 있으니까 그게 이게 가장 큰 장점이요. 자유롭다는 거예요.
Mr. Cho, a former plant engineer, is one of about a dozen so-called silver delivery men at this courier firm. It hires only elderly couriers and uses that as its draw card. In South Korea, most workers are pushed to retire by 60 years old and often have to downgrade to menial jobs if they hope to rejoin the workforce. Many do so partly to supplement slim pensions, which come up to less than $110 each month for Mr. Cho.
제가 은퇴하고 나서 이제 집에서 이제 맨날 취미생활하고 산에나 다니고 뭐 왔다 갔다 하다가 그 좀 무의미한 것 같아서 그래도 뭔가 보람된 일을 하면서 뭐 하는 게 없을까 하다가 우연히 누가 소개를 해주더라고요. 노인들은 또 건강을 많이 생각해야 되잖아요. 또 약간의 용돈도 거기에 일거 양도 이거 좋을 것 같다 그래서 저는 하여간 즐기면서 하여간 재미있게 하고 있습니다.
Seniors over the age of 65 make up about 19% of South Korea's population. By 2050, the figure could be as high as 44%. As life expectancies increase, there are fears the elderly will spend a longer period after retirement without income or purpose, but enter a new generation of liberated, independent, and often educated baby boomers were opening doors and changing perceptions.
자녀들 키우고 그다음에 이제 손주들 케어하고 그러다 보니까 제가 굉장히 묻혀버린 거예요. 그래서 무슨 이렇게 커뮤니티가 좀 있어야 될 것 같은데 저는 우선적으로 경험을 하기 위해서 나왔거든요. 여러 가지를 만나보고 내 역량이 어디까지인지 그거를 좀 한번 경험해보려고 나왔어요.
Kim Nanhyang is here at the Seoul Senior Employment Support Center to look for work. Her dream is to be a docent, but she lacks experience. Rather than sit around passively, she says she will just seize any opportunity her counselor sends her way. She's ready to begin the next chapter of her life, wherever it takes her.
사회봉사활동도 좀 하면서 경제적인 거로 좀 이렇게 매칭이 된다면 더 큰 보람이 있을 것 같고 내 역량이 좀 되는구나 내 자부심도 생길 것 같고 그런 생각도 들고 이제 앞으로 또 그걸 통해서 창업을 좀 해보려고 준비도 하고 있어요.
Employment centers like this identify companies seeking to hire seniors and offer training for those making a career switch. But it suggests what elderly job seekers really need is reassurance.
일단 내가 일을 할 수 있냐부터 시작을 하세요. 그리고 또 노인을 채용하는 곳들이 있냐. 근데 거의 대부분은 이제 그런 정보가 없는 분들이 많으세요. 그래서 어떤 일자리를 참여할 수 있는지 그리고 내가 어떤 역량을 갖추어야 하는지에 대해서도 막막해 하시거든요. 부에서 제공하는 취업 상담도 있지만 그곳에 가면 젊은 사람들이 주로 많이 오기 때문에 어르신은 좀 그 부분에서 정보에서 좀 소외될 수 있어요.
South Korea has the highest old age poverty rate among economies in the OECD grouping. 4 out of 10 seniors live below the poverty line. But some experts say the situation is set to ease due to gradual expansions in pension coverage and a growing focus on job creation for the elderly and government budgets.
노동의 성과에 따른 보상이라기보다는 일종의 그 사회복지 급여 같은 측면이 강했는데 현재 이제 노인이 되는 사람들 같은 경우에는 그런 어떤 공공형 일자리보다는 시장형 일자리. 그래서 그 뭐 스타트업이라든지 뭐 이렇게 좀 경쟁할 수 있고 또 스스로 뭔가 할 수 있는 자영업, 창업을 지원한다든지 정년 연령의 유연화도 필요할 것 같고.
Already, the elderly is filling more than half of new jobs created in South Korea. In contrast, only 1% of newly created positions went to workers in their 20s or younger in 2022. Professor Jung suggests strengthening lifelong education, particularly vocational training tailored for older workers. But as unions press to raise the retirement age, there are fears South Korea could be poised for a contest for jobs between seniors and youth struggling to find work.
Yunokja is probably one of the world's oldest elementary school students. The 82-year-old didn't have a chance to attend school when she was a kid.
그냥 우리네 이름만 쓰고 그냥 어디 가서 쓰라는 것만 썼지 그냥 우리가 이제 저는 이렇게 뭐 쓰지는 못했어요. 우리 시대만 해도 우리가 저기 9살 때 유교가 났어요. 유교가 나가지고 엄마, 누나, 저 동생, 언니 다 죽고 걔하고 셋이 남았어.
Decades ago in South Korea, girls were usually not given an education as they had to help their parents make ends meet or stay home to take care of their young siblings while the parents went out to work. 4 years ago, a door was opened for the octogenarian to start attending this school in Yangpyeong County in Gyeonggi Province. Hoseong Elementary School has been facing a crisis. It literally ran out of students as there were nearly no more young children in Yangpyeong. Unable to survive on its own, it has since been absorbed into a larger school in the same Yangpyeong County. But as the country's demographic crisis deepened, one day an idea struck the principal of the school.
우리 마을에 혹시 학교를 안 다니셨던 할머니들이 어른들이 계실 텐데 그분들 학교 다니게 하면 좋겠다 그런 생각을 하고 마을에 가서 이제 알아보니까 학교에서 받아주기만 하면 우리는 다닐 의향이 있다 그런 분들이 계셨어요. 그래서
In 2021, four grandmothers, including Madame Yoon and a friend, Chung Sun Dok, enrolled, starting their first grade education along with 13 young children.
기분이 좋아요. 옛날에 어려서 학교를 못 갔걸랑요. 그래가지고 시골에서 그냥 농사 지면서 사는 게 이게 아주 고통스러웠어요. 1학년에 들어와서 그 해고 보니까는 시방 생각에는 내가 그때에 학교 안 왔으면 어떻게 3년이라는 세월을 어떻게 보냈나 싶은 생각이 나요 아주.
나 너무 행복하다. 내가 평생 이렇게 행복할지 몰랐다 이런 얘기를 하시는데 아 우리가 여기까지 생각을 못했었는데 그런 이야기를 들을 때 아 참 잘했다 우리가 뭐 그런 생각을 하죠.
But the size of the class shrank again last year as the other two grandmothers couldn't continue due to their health conditions.
Now, schools across South Korea, like this one, face the risk of closure these days, and so they need these grandmothers to survive. But they have their own objective. They're here to learn how to read and write.
The teacher in charge of the octogenarian students says it took some time getting used to for everyone.
저희가 처음에 너무 이제 학생으로 대하지 않고 할머니로 막 모시게 된 거예요. 처음에 이렇게 처음이다 보니까 그래서 서로 이제 너무 격을 막 세우고 이렇게 조심조심 하다 보니까 더 불편했던 것 같은데 이제 3년째 되고 하니까 서로 이제 많이 알고 하니까.
And these students are eager to learn, she says. When Grandma Chong returns home from school, she takes her books out and continues studying. Her son says his mother has been very happy since attending the elementary school, which he also attended when he was young. He says then there were about 40 to 50 students in one class.
이제 실제로 쓸 때는 못 썼는데 이제 여기 학교 들어가시면서 지금 이제 3학년이니까 많이 늦으신 거예요. 이제 지금은 뭐 보내는 거 이런 거 다 당신 손으로 쓰시고. 그러니까 좋죠, 뭐.
She says she's hoping she can continue to study and finish elementary school at the very least. Not your usual fashion show. Some of these models gracing the runway at this event at a hotel in the glitzy Gangnam district are in their 70s and 80s. Together by the Senior Model Association of South Korea, the stage allows the elderly, like Park Woo-hae, to finally realize her catwalk dream.
키가 커야 되더라고. 그래서 못했지. 그래가 한이 돼가지고 있다가 아 지금 just timing. 왜냐하면 키가 작아도 되고 패션 만 열정만 있으면 되거든. 근데 지금 너무 재밌고 여자들이 그냥 시니어 때 제일 즐길 수 있는 게 이게 아닌가 하는 생각이 들어요.
Ha Yoon-jung became a member of the association about a year ago. The activity makes her feel motivated to wake up every morning.
좋죠. 네. 여기 오면 힘이 생기고 젊어진 것 같아요. 마음이. 그래서 좋아요. 딸이 이걸 알고 이렇게 해줘서 관심이야 있었지요. 있지만 또 그 뭐 누가 이렇게 소개 안 해주면은 그렇잖아요. 엄마들이 가기가 좀 힘들잖아요. 근데 딸이 소개를 해서 알고 왔어요.
Good morning, everybody. Happy day.
Once every week for 2 hours, the elderly aspirants meet here at the Senior Model Association, a non-profit body set up about 70 years ago. The minimum age for members is 45, and they are given proper catwalk training. Trainer Kim Moo-young, a former model himself, says it was not easy in the beginning for him to train the seniors given their age gap.
심리적으로 어려웠는데 제가 학생들도 가르쳐보고 시니어도 가르쳐봤는데 오히려 학생들보다 시니어가 더 열정이 있고 교육을 받으려는 태도가 훨씬 더 좋아요. 꺼진 불을 다시 키우니까 활활 타오르는 것 같아요, 더.
It's a pity, he says, that there's not that much demand for senior models in South Korea. Unlike in the West, where it's not unusual for models in their 60s and 70s to make a name for themselves, South Korea is set to become a super-aged society in 2025, when people over the age of 65 will account for 20% of the total population of 52 million.
But South Korea may not be ready for that. According to Statistics Korea, in every 10 elderly South Koreans, 6 or more are grappling with insufficient income. That, as the number of people aged 65 or older who live alone is also edging up.
Experts say it is critical that the South Korean government comes out with policies to address the demographic shift and create new runways for its elderly population, the generation who played a key role in the reconstruction of the country. From the ashes of the Korean War and the Japanese colonial rule.